If your system looks like rainbow puke, you're doing it wrong. Sometimes less is more, and by the time you realize it, it might be too late. In this video, I want to go over everything you can RGB in your system, plus some really cool lighting accessories, actually interesting lighting effects, and some things to be aware of when RGB gets out of hand. This is how to properly RGB your PC. We're stuck at home anyway, might as well make it worth our while. But if RGBing your PC isn't your thing, a simple RGB light bulb is a fantastic way to add color to any space. Links below for everything we'll talk about in this video.
Power up your PC with Be Quiet's Straight Power 11 Platinum Series, featuring 80 plus platinum efficiency, a fully modular design, high quality Japanese capacitors, and a silent wings fan that's optimized for airflow and silence. Choose Be Quiet and your components will thank you.
All right, so my first tip revolves around color coordination and complementing colors. So this is the color scheme I've settled with my water-cooled machine, all soft blue lighting with a hint of purple, and I'm trying to make sure there's color harmony in here where colors don't clash and complement each other. I refer to the color wheel to see what opposite colors work together or sticking to neighboring colors for a more monochrome look. Unfortunately, light colors on any RGB hardware looks pretty terrible. Like this light yellow or light green, or even getting pure white is almost never possible, so vibrant colors always look much better if you stick to the edge of the color wheel. Now, some LED strips have a white channel too, which is great, identified as RGBW to give you pure white, but it also requires this almost proprietary 5-pin RGBW connector on the motherboards, which is not very common and currently only found on some Gigabyte boards. Bonus tip, since all my water cooling components and all the lighting accessories are from Corsair, everything is controlled via IQ software, which is pretty easy to use. But did you know we have this hardware lighting option? That means all the lighting accessories will default to the color you choose, even if IQ isn't running. So in situations where the Windows is booting or you're in BIOS, you can still display the color you want without it loading IQ software. My favorite effects for memory are rain, alternating colors, and sequential. Really love the dual color dynamic animations on these Dominator Platinum dims because of Capellix LEDs. And to me, this is the best RGB illumination on any memory, while more traditional lighting, like on G-Skill Trident Z, is best kept static. But I really appreciate the soft and uniformity of that Trident Z RGB illumination. Nicely done. And now let's move on to some awesome lighting accessories. I really appreciate Fantex doing ambient lighting right with neon LED strips. And these are cool because they're completely flexible, so you can guide them around the motherboard or particular sections of your case and highlight certain pieces of the hardware. They're available in different lengths and can daisy chain with each other or Fantex other accessories like deluxe frames. And I simply love the softness of the glow, which is possible thanks to that massive diffusion layer. And color vibrancy is a bonus because it is absolutely gorgeous. Plus, these installation adapters are low profile and are easy to install either with these adhesive or screwed into the motherboard standoffs. Bonus tip, if you have the digital ARGB controller, which has three LED channels, you can connect multiple neon strips. Next up, one of my favorite ways to add simple color to a build is to use Lux fan frames from Fantex. I've used these many times on my favorite performance fans to add some tasteful bling without the need to buy an actual RGB fan. On white blades, we get the most illumination, but black or brown blades look sweet too, and it's awesome for the rear exhaust fan, as that's guaranteed to be in view. The aluminum frames add a little bit luxury but also cost a bit more, but the cheaper plastic frames from a lighting perspective work just the same. Bonus tip, they can be installed on either side of the fan and controlled via the 5-volt ARGB connector or through Fantex's own case hub lighting. And bonus tip number two, if you can combine the Lux frames with an actual RGB fan, you can create some really cool dual tone color variations, especially if the actual Lux fan frame is behind the fan. I think it looks really cool. Now, what happens when RGB hardware does not match in color? Like, none of the colors on this Lian Li fan matches to my neon strip. Well, this is a perfect time to introduce a color accent, again referring to the color wheel, and making the most sense of this bling situation. Like, going for a more monochrome style lighting and keeping to the same family of color, or adjusting the hue on the accessory with the most options to find something that works together. And even with accessories that come from the same brand, you might sometimes still have variation in color presets. Like in my water-cooled build, the RAM yellow does not match the yellow on the fans, or the actual pump or the GPU block. So I have to play around with the wheel to give me the exact sort of visual match. But yeah, use the color wheel to your advantage. Now, I'm a strong believer in less is more when it comes to RGB, and I really like NZXT's latest pump design. It's a cool hybrid to display some hardware temps or full colored GIFs that is very unique, and I wouldn't run solid colors on here because I feel like that's kind of wasteful, but it displays beautiful gradients that you can easily customize and match with the overall color palette, like my purple and light blue gradient from this Lux frame. And bonus tip, you can actually flip the image on the pump to match the orientation of the tubes. Another cool lighting product is the Hue 2, also from NZXT, and this kit is designed to be installed behind your monitor for this cool ambient spill that in real time complements the colors on the screen. This, however, can also be installed behind your desk if you're going for that full underglow effect. And I will say that cam software has been a lot more stable for me with these products than it has in the past, and like actually boots up when I launch the system and it recognizes all the accessories. But man, it is a lot to handle when it comes to wiring. Bonus tip, you can install a set of underglow strips below your case for some extra shine on the exterior, but I don't particularly like these because the LEDs are not diffused and are quite harsh, and that is why I really appreciate the neon strips from Fantex. And bonus tip number two, I will repeat this again, an ambient RGB light bulb goes a long way to add some beautiful color to your space. You don't have to fully bling out your PC if you want a little bit of RGB. Okay, unintentional rhyme, I'll take it. Unfortunately, all this bling comes with various challenges. So number one, cable management is an absolute nightmare with RGB fans in particular, because we have two cables per fan and sometimes they don't even plug into the same area. But if they're going into a hub, I like to zip tie the cables in three sections and then collect them together to eliminate even more bulk. When routing something like the neon strips, I like to place the end of the strip where the cable can exit through a cutout so the connector doesn't have to cross any hardware. When I was installing the Hue 2 set, yeah, that was not really comfortable to do cable management with, and that is just something you have to accept. And the next big challenge when it comes to RGB is definitely software. So if you stick to one brand, it's simple. I prefer Corsair's IQ because it connects all my Corsair hubs, so the Commander Pro and the Lighting Note Pro, so I can change the lighting of my Corsair fans, the memory, and whatever lighting strips I plug into the Commander Pro. And it's the same story with cam software, either detecting the Hue strips or configuring the Kraken cooler, but pretty much everything else must be plugged into the RGB headers on the motherboard, either the 5-volt addressable header or the 12-volt RGB. So with the 5-volt headers, each individual LED on the strip can display a different color with more interesting effects, like you see with ambient lighting on this Hue 2, while the more traditional 12-volt RGB strip can display a single color at the same time, so that is your difference. And these are not interchangeable, you will destroy the RGB hardware if the 12 volt is plugged into 5 volt and vice versa. And the next crappy thing is that RGB software across brands from ASUS, MSI, Gigabyte, ASRock isn't exactly stable. So my RGB SSD lights up perfectly fine on ASUS motherboards but doesn't work with ASRock. Why? Theoretically, they share the same 5-volt addressable connector, but something in the software isn't communicating to the other RGB hardware properly. Which is why I like Corsair's approach with the Commander Pro, because everything plugs into that and it has not failed me since. I really like Fantex's approach too, where you can connect all the lighting accessories to the case and not rely on software. Maybe your motherboard doesn't even have the proper 5-volt or 12-volt addressable connectors. The 12-volt is not addressable, the 5-volt is. Luckily, I have not had any issues with RGB memory on any of my motherboards. They simply light up and are easily controllable through the motherboard's own RGB software, or a sync, Mystic Light, Fusion something, and then the polychrome thing from ASRock. But still, not having the confidence of one RGB peripheral working with ASUS, but not working with other is extremely annoying. And I think we need to move into a direction where that becomes not something we have to think about. All right, so those are all my RGB tips. I would love to hear how you handle both lighting and color for your personal system. Let me know in the comments below. I'm Dmitry, thanks so much for watching. Check out this other relevant content. As usual, everything will be listed in the description. Thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you in the next video.